Welcome back to the iiQKA and LBR Easy Getting Started video series. You've already seen a lot about how to set up your first pick and place application using things like inputs and outputs to turn on lights. In this video, I'd like to focus more on some advanced elements, specifically related to the if-else node and how to use a conditional input statement such as a switch being left or right. In this case, left block start position or right block start position. First, we need to configure this switch. To do that, we go to the configuration screen, inputs and outputs. And again, you'll see a list of all the physical IOs that are available to you. Here, I know I plugged that into input pin 4. Just create a new mapping there, new signal, give it a name, in this case, switch. Make sure the direction is input and press create new signal. Go ahead and apply that. Then I can go check that in the signals, scroll down, see where the new switch is, and then I can check it. So right now you see that it's on true when it's in the left position, and you see it switches to false there when it's in the right position. Ready to use in our program. So here you see the same pick and place application we've already programmed. But now I've taken all the movements and put them inside of a subsequence called pick and place sequence left. I want to go ahead and take that and copy it because later on we'll use two of them for each of the branches of the if-else statement. Do that by copying the whole branch and then pasting it at the end of the main sequence. We'll come back to that in a minute. Now I want to go ahead and add my if-else statement. Next thing to do is add in our if-else node and just drag that in here right after the initialize sequence. And in that if-else node, we first want to add two branches. So now we've got one if it's on the left position, else it's the right position. And there you see our two branches. Give them a name. In this case, the entire thing. We'll call it left or right. For the first if branch, we'll call it left. And then for the second branch, we'll call it right. For that left branch, we want to make sure that we set it to the same signal as when it's turned to the left. In that case, we're looking at selecting the switch signal. And just to be sure we got our logic right, we know that if it's on the left, it's true. The other branch only happens if that's not true. So obviously it's going to be the only other option, which is right. So we got our two branches. We want to drag the pick sequence into each of them. So for the first one, pick place sequence left. And the next branch, pick place sequence left as well. Of course, all the motions in this are still as if it was starting in the left. So we have to go through and change them so it goes from right to left. But for simplicity's sake, we'll assume you've already done that. All that's left to do then is test it. For that, take a step back, make sure you're in test mode, press the enabling switch, and either press the play button on the front of the smart pad or the green button on the back. We'll run it through each position, robot moving, we can see the gripper working, the if-else statement is working, went to the correct starting position, lights are operating like we expect, back to home. Now, let's switch it and test the other starting position. Press the enabling switch, press the green button. There we go. We know the switches work. Making sure everything's going the way we like. Now you've learned how to use an if-else statement in your program and how to set it based on external inputs. I think you're ready to keep on learning on your own. But if you ever get stuck, there's help built right into the user interface here. In this help screen, you can see a table of contents with all sorts of topics, programming, input and output, gripper and tools. And if you look at any of these, you can scroll through the text, read it, look at the images. It'll help you get through any little road bumps you might encounter. If you don't want to read it on the screen here on the smart pad, you can scan the QR code and you'll be taken to the same information on KUKA Expert Online. And while you're there, you can look at video tutorials, as well as go to my.kuka and access the iiQKA community forum, where you can interact with other users for best practices or ask KUKA questions directly. Hope you enjoyed learning about the powerful simplicity of iiQKA and LBR Easy. Happy exploring. Thanks for watching.
industrial intelligence.